Well, let us see what is the next option, next object, next mesh that Blender has provided us with. I will select this cube and hit delete button, go to add, go to mesh, and then take the next object, which is cube. With the cube taken, here we get a sub menu, and what we can do is change the size of this object. We can align it to according to the world, according to the view, wherever we are seeing from. If we are seeing from this side, and if I go to align and take view, it is going to align it according to where we are seeing, from where we are seeing. And 3D cursor, this red and white dotted circle is called 3D cursor. It's like a boon for manipulating objects. We will be seeing that in the further coming videos. So until now, we will see what 3D cursor does. As it says, however our 3D cursor is set, according to that the cube is being set. Along with that, we have been provided location. We can change it in x axis, in y axis, in z axis, also rotate it along x axis, along y axis, and along z axis. And one more thing to remember is that when we are rotating this, this is now rotating according to the global axis, means according to the Blender's axis. We are not rotating it according to the that object axis. So that one thing is to be remembered. So one more thing, one more tip I want to say is Alt G to bring it back to where it was, Alt R to rotate it by default how it was first when we took the cube, and Alt S is if I scale it a little bit, and Alt S, it's going to scale it back to where it was first brought into the Blender. That time what was the scale, it is going to scale it according to that size. So with that being said, hit the like button if you like this video, hit the subscribe button, and if you want to wholeheartedly support me, there is a Patreon page, links will be given in the description. And with that being said and done, try to see it, learn it, understand it. I will be seeing you in the next video.